मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम। वेलकम टू चैप्टर 4, दैट इज एयर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी रिविजन लेक्चर। ओके, नाउ दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द पार्ट 1 ऑफ द ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 4। नाउ लेट इज बिगिन। सो चिल्ड्रेन, नाउ लेट इज अंडरस्टैंड वॉट ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन। ओके, so we are going to revise about importance of air, we're going to revise on composition of the atmosphere and the structure of the atmosphere. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is importance of air. Children, we all know that air consists of several gases. One of them is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is also known as a greenhouse gas. The sun's rays warm the earth. This we all know, isn't it? So, the part of the sun's rays, so when the sun's rays fall on the earth, the part of the sun's rays are absorbed by the earth and some of the rays are reflected back in the space. Now, this part of the reflected rays is trapped by the greenhouse gas, and these trapped radiations of the sun warm the earth. Otherwise, our earth would have been a very difficult place to live in, especially in cold seasons. So, what does greenhouse gas consist of? It consists of carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide. Okay, so now let us see why are they called greenhouse gases. Okay, or rather we will see why carbon dioxide is called as a greenhouse gas. So children, what are greenhouse gases? Let us understand that first. Carbon dioxide, methane and nitrous oxide, all these three are the greenhouse gases. But why is carbon dioxide called as greenhouse gas? Children, just like in a nursery, we see greenhouse in which sun's rays come in but cannot go out. The trapped heat warms the greenhouse. Similarly, as these gases trap the sun's rays, so children, what are greenhouse gases? Let us understand that first. Carbon dioxide, methane and nitrous oxide, all these three are the greenhouse gases. But why is carbon dioxide called as greenhouse gas? Children, just like in a nursery, we see greenhouse in which sun's rays come in but cannot go out. The trapped heat warms the greenhouse. Similarly, as these gases trap sun's heat, they are called greenhouse gases. If there would have been no greenhouse to trap the sun's radiation, the earth would be a very cold place where we would not be able to survive. So now with greenhouse, let us understand what is global warming also. When the level of the greenhouse gases increases in the atmosphere due to factory smoke or maybe due to car fumes, the heat retained increases the temperature. It increases temperature of what? Temperature of the earth. This is called the global warming. Now let us revise the next topic, that is composition of air or composition of atmosphere. children, atmosphere is the mixture of various gases. Nitrogen and oxygen are the two gases which makes bulk of the atmosphere. Nitrogen is 78% available and oxygen is 21% available, right? What, which are the other gases found? Other gases are carbon dioxide, argon, etc. Okay? So, children, carbon dioxide, helium, ozone, argon and hydrogen, all these gases are found in lesser quantities. Nitrogen is the most plentiful gas in the air. When we inhale, we take some part of nitrogen inside us, inside our lungs, and exhale, and when we exhale, okay, what do we give out? We give out carbon dioxide and nitrogen. But plants need nitrogen for their survival. They cannot take nitrogen from air directly. Bacteria from the soil and the roots of the plant take nitrogen from air and change its form so that plants can use it for its survival. Oxygen is the second most plentiful gas in the air. Humans and animals take in oxygen from air as they breathe. Carbon dioxide is used by the plants for inhaling and also to make their food. Green plants produce oxygen during photosynthesis. In this way, oxygen content in the air remains constant. So, as I said that green plants need carbon dioxide to make their food, humans and animals release carbon dioxide. So, basically the amount of carbon dioxide released by humans or animals seems to be equal to the amount used by the plants, which makes a perfect balance. However, this kind of balance is upset by burning of fuels such as coal and oil. It adds billions of tons of carbon dioxide, affecting the earth's weather and climate. Now let us move on with structure of atmosphere. Our atmosphere is divided into 5 layers, starting from the earth's surface. These are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. Now let us revise it with the help of the diagram. Yeah, so can you see this picture, children? Troposphere is the most important layer. It is the first layer and the most important layer. The air that we breathe, okay, exists here. All the weather phenomena like rainfall, fog, storm occur over here. So, it is the most important layer of the atmosphere. Its average height is about 13 kilometers. The air that we breathe exists here, and almost all the weather phenomena like rainfall, snow, sleet, fog and hail occur in this layer. After troposphere comes the stratosphere. The stratosphere extends above the troposphere up to the height of 50 kilometers. This layer is free from the clouds and associated weather phenomena hence making it ideal for flying aeroplanes. It contains ozone layer, which protects us from the harmful effects of the sun's rays. Now we move on to the next sphere. Above stratosphere comes the mesosphere. This is the third layer of the atmosphere. It lies above the stratosphere, just as I said, and it extends to the height of 80 kilometers. Meteorites burn up in this layer on entering the space. Above mesosphere comes the fourth layer, that is the thermosphere. In thermosphere, temperature rises very rapidly with increasing height. Ionosphere is a part of this layer. So, thermosphere is also known as ionosphere. It extends between 80 to 400 kilometers. This layer helps in radio transmission. In fact, radio waves transmitted from the Earth are reflected back to the Earth by the layer, that is by thermosphere. Now we move on to the fifth layer, that is exosphere. The uppermost layer of the atmosphere is known as the exosphere. The layer has a very thin air. Light gases like helium and hydrogen float into the space from here. Children, now is the time for your favorite session, that is quiz time. So, should we begin? Come on. Let us see what the first question is. Dash released in the atmosphere creates a greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiated from the sun. And the options are carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen, and none of the above. So, what can be the answer, children? Let us see what the answer is. Answer is carbon dioxide. Yes, carbon dioxide released in the atmosphere creates a greenhouse effect by trapping the heat radiated from the earth. Now, let us move on to the second question. One of the important feature of dash is that it contains a layer of ozone gas. And the options are mesosphere, stratosphere, exosphere, and none of the above. And what is the answer, children? Answer is stratosphere. Yes. So, one of the important feature of stratosphere is that it contains a layer of ozone gas. Next question. The most plentiful gas in the atmosphere is oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, ozone. So, these are the four options: A, oxygen; B, carbon dioxide; C, nitrogen; and D, ozone. So, what is the answer? What should be the correct answer? Let us see. The answer is nitrogen. The most plentiful gas in the atmosphere is the nitrogen gas. Yes. So, children, with this, I end this part of the revision session. See you in the second part of the same chapter. Till then, goodbye and keep learning.